and welcome to my channel. Today I've got a wholly different type of video for you than I usually do. The last couple of months I've really been into watching sewing videos. Now, I'm definitely not going to try to make my own clothes anytime soon because I have a full-time job, I have a YouTube channel, I have hobbies and I also enjoy sleeping. So, yeah, there's only 24 hours in a day and 7 days in a week and I don't have time to try and make my own clothes. However, I did think it might be a fun idea to redo some clothes, or at least like take some parts apart and sew them back together in a way that will hopefully make them fit better. This is a work shirt. It's freshly washed. I just smelled my laundry detergent and it's so nice. Anyway, so yeah, multiple reasons I'm using this shirt. For start, this is one of a few shirts that actually doesn't fit me at all. Like, it's just awkwardly wide at the waist. I'll show you in a moment. But also, if I mess it up, well, it doesn't look good to begin with, so it won't really look worse. And if I really mess it up, I can always ask for a new one at work. This is probably not like ethically okay to like think about it like that, but still. Also, I'm not stupid enough today to cut into anything. I'm just going to sew parts together. So if I mess it up, well, I'll really just be able to just tear the, you know, like tear the like little... I don't even know what this is called in English. Well, you know, I'll be able to pull the threads out and just, you know, redo it or not redo it and just leave it as is. So yeah, that's what we're gonna do today. Okay, so you can probably immediately see the problem. Basically, let me explain. The problem I have with most blouses is that if it fits at the shoulders, it's not gonna fit at the waist. Especially if they're like very straight and not, you know, actually, yeah, nicely shaped and all. So yeah, this is, I think, either a size 38, European sizes, or a size small, I'm not even sure. But anyway, it fits at my shoulders. It's actually a little tight at my shoulders, but at the waist it's really, really wide. And I like to stuff my blouse in my trousers. And then it just poofs up and it looks ridiculous and lumpy and very not flattering at all. So, it already sort of has darts. I spent like 2 minutes of like research on Google to see how you could do darts in clothing, so I'm an expert now. Not at all. But anyway, my idea is to make these darts deeper, so that hopefully, you know, if I tighten these parts, then hopefully it will just entirely look better and actually form-fitting instead of too wide. So yeah, I have these little pins. So let's go for it. Okay, so the idea is to get it symmetrical, and it also just occurred to me that if I want to do this correctly, I should probably put this on inside out so I can actually pin it the correct way. We're getting on to something here. Okay, so we're here. I just did one button and safety pinned it because I couldn't be bothered. Anyway, so as you can tell, there's already darts here, so yeah, I'm just going to try to pin them all the way to the bottom from like narrow here to wide here to make sure that it actually goes tight. Wish me luck. Okay, so it just occurred to me that I cannot do this for the life of me while I'm wearing it. So, instead I'm just going to measure it like this and figure out that I'm probably going to need 1.5 centimeters on each side. Maybe 2 to actually get this to be tight and yet still be able to move around in it. So, that's the plan. I'm going to take this off now, do that separately and then put it on again so I can actually check if it fits before I sew it together. Yeah. Okay, so what I've done here is I've made a line and I've just... It's the inside anyway, so I'll use the pen. I'm going to do the exact same thing on the other side. I hope. And just pull it from here to here. Making sure the bottom side is also flat. Hopefully. And pulling it about 2 centimeters in. Like so. So I can then just, you know, sew it together, hopefully. Okay, so I think it's acceptably symmetrical, so I'm going to pin it now. Take Okay, so I think it worked. You don't want to know how paranoid I am about the sharp objects now lining my body. But anyways, seriously, good at the shoulders, down here I took like 5 centimeters off. What size is this even? Anyway, I think it worked, because now it's nice around my waist and I can still move carefully with the needles. But I can still move, you know, normally, so I think we're good. So yeah, I'm going to sew this together, which is going to take approximately 5 million years by hand. Okay, so I've got a needle and a thread that's about the same color as this shirt. I think I'm going to do a backstitch. I know what stitch I'm going to do, I just am not sure if it's actually a backstitch. But I'm going to do the thing where you make a stitch and then go back over the stitch to make it very sturdy. So I've grabbed enough of the yarn thing, thread. That I can go over it twice and a little bit more, because I know me and I know I need a lot of space to do a knot at the end. So yeah, let's go for it. Okay, so the technique I'm going to use to tie up the thread is a very professional one named, if you don't know how to do something properly, at least do it very sturdily. So I'm just gonna tie a 3-triple knot in it. Okay, so it sort of reminds me of Frankenstein's monster. But it actually looks better than I anticipated, which I suppose says a lot. Yeah, let's do the other side. Okay, so we're done. Here's the shirt inside our outside in. The correct way around, okay? So this was the first side I did, and of course you can tell this is the original stitching, this is what I made of it. There is a very distinct difference in quality and craftsmanship. Also, this was definitely done by machine. But this was the second side that I did, this side. I do think it's actually neater than the first side that I did, so practice makes perfect, I guess, which is good because I also have a second work shirt which I'm also going to have to fix like this. So yeah, let's put it on and see how it looks now. And here you can see the final result. I gotta admit, it's not absolutely perfect because it is still sort of like bulging at the back. But let's face it, that requires skills that I do not have and I have no idea how to fix that. So I'm just gonna focus on the front because that's what matters, because I'm that vain. And on the front it actually looks a whole lot better. It looks a whole lot smoother and nicer and I really, really like it. I'll just come a little bit closer so you can properly see. Yeah, it's actually quite symmetrical. Of course, you can see this whole like toink, toink, toink shape here, but it doesn't matter because my trousers rise up to here, so whatever. So yeah, I'm actually, to my own surprise, pleased with it. And that leaves us with the final result. I gotta say, I'm really, really pleased with it. And yeah, I hope it was useful for you if you have clothes that you sort of want to redo, but aren't sure, you know, if you dare to do so. Just try it, and at worst you will have to like undo it and whatever. Just go for it, as long as it's not something very expensive, at least. Like, I wouldn't advise you to risk it. But you know, just start practicing with something you don't really mind going wrong. Yeah. So yeah, at any rate, if you enjoyed this video, please click the like button, it would really help me out. If you want to see more of my videos, you can always subscribe to my channel. For now, as always, thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you have a wonderful day, and I hope to see you next time. Bye!